All right, in some breaking news coming in, the board of Adani Enterprises Limited has decided not to go ahead with the fully subscribed follow-on public offer or FPO. The further public offer of equity shares aggregating up to 20,000 crore of face value, 1 rupee each on partly paid up basis, was fully subscribed. The official statement says, and I quote, given the unprecedented situation and the current market volatility, the company aims to protect the interests of its investing community by returning the FPO proceeds and withdraws the completed transaction. In fact, a press release has been issued by the Adani Group in just the last few minutes where the company has said that the interest of the investors is paramount, and hence to insulate them from any potential financial losses, the board has decided not to go ahead with the FPO. Our business editor Rahul joining me on the phone line at this stage. Rahul, this is a very significant development, coming as it does just days after the Hindenburg storm, as it were, began brewing. Put this into perspective for our viewers. What does this development really mean?
2 points here. First, the Adani Group is obviously thinking that if they go ahead with the FPO, then everybody will think that that's how they're going to pay off their debt, which is due shortly. About 315 million is due this month for their bonds. So if they go ahead with the FPO, then everybody will think that the Hindenburg report is absolutely true, and they don't want to give that kind of an indication at this point. That's one reason. The other is, like they have said, to get some kind of shareholder confidence back after losing about 90 billion of value across the group firms. So that's one. And the biggest news probably is also a Credit Suisse not accepting Adani Group's assets as collateral for lending money to its clients, and they have said they're not going to accept any of Adani notes, and so for the margin calls they have to pledge some other assets. That's another news that's not helping either.
Rahul, the news does keep getting worse for the Adani Group. This seems to be the second big development of the day as far as this entire controversy regarding the Adani Group and the Hindenburg report is concerned, because earlier this evening we reported that the Indian market regulator, the SEBI, the Securities and Exchange Board of India, is undertaking a full-scale examination of the fall in Adani shares. That is what sources have been quoted as saying. Can you tell us more about that?
True, but that is more to understand if there has been any kind of irregularity in those trades. Maybe they're looking at who are the ones who are selling to make a quick buck and things like that. That is more in favor of Adani rather than against them. But the SEBI is already investigating, and if they find some other information from the Hindenburg report, which they can use and put the group under the scanner even further, that is something that people are thinking at this point. Investors are clearly thinking about it. I think the FPO cancellation is clear because there was 12% of retail investors interested. That itself is a story. Forget that it was 100% subscribed. That was coming from large investors. That's not how a follow-on share for such a huge group, which became so popular so quickly, it doesn't work that way.
Final question, Rahul, before we let you go, does all of this really mean that investor confidence in the Adani Group has been very, very strongly hit? Does this come, in a sense, as an acknowledgement of that?
Yes, it does. It's very clear because a third of the value of the group's stock is completely wiped out, which means if I had, let's say, one share in each of those companies, and if I paid $100, I'm down $30 on that right out. So that's a huge hit to any investor's portfolio, one. Two, those who invest just for profits are already thinking they burned their shirt and they're trying to exit. That's another reason. industry, investors have lost confidence. Otherwise, a group stock fall cannot be this deep.
All right, so a massive development there. We'll really have to wait and see what ramifications this has. Rahul, thanks very much for sharing all those details with us.
Thank you.